National Railway Museum in York. I'm on holiday going to Manchester. But I'm at the museum. I hope you enjoy the video. And first thing I can see is a steam engine. I've actually been to this museum before, but I haven't been since 2015, I think. So, 2015. So, yeah. Anyways, enjoy the video. Right, I can see another steam train. Let's go take a look at it. Let's see what the name of it is. It's called LMS, built in 1926 in Horwich. It's in Norwich, but turns out it says Horwich. It's very dark in here, so yeah. Looks nice, 13,000. This is the cab. Wouldn't go in there if I were you, because it's modern, I think. These are the handles where you would have pulled them in the early 1900s, so wow, it doesn't work, I don't think, so these were the handles you would have pulled on the HSTs as well. Sadly, they've gone for retirement. This is the Gladstone steam train. It's orange, and if you walk a bit more, it's the same. It's the same carriage. I think it's the same carriage. As the LMS. Was it LMS? Yes, it was. It looks very old, actually. But it looks very very intriguing, as I should say. Anyways, let's carry on. The next one we have. I thought that was an underground train at first, but it's not. This kind of looks like the BR Class 52 that I play on the West Somerset Railway on Trains and World. I don't think I'm allowed to open it, so no, I wouldn't if I were you. So, it's a diesel train, I think. Also a steam train as well. Like the door handles. You wouldn't do that now because I think people would have opened them whilst the train was moving, and that's dangerous. Now here's the TV with fire in a burning coal or something. They're peeling a train sign off. That's a bit sad. Okay, carrying on. Here's a ER class 47, I believe. And it's called the Royal Scot. This is on the West Somerset Railway. Let's take a look at this one. Hold on, let me just get a bit closer. Here we go, the Royal Scot. Look at this. Look at this beauty. This is the Pullman trains. One of those old HSTs. And if you look inside, it looks very real, like in real life. Here's the LMS again. This is the Midland, and you've got some nice forks and a nice thing where a nice table inside the carriage, like you would get on the other National Rail trains in real life. It probably wouldn't be like this now. Mm-hmm. 673. LSWR, I think it's London South Western Railway. Looks, it's just a beauty, isn't it? Common in the section which your favourite steam train is. Now here's one sign I like. We've got obsessed with train spotting. We'd stand for hours, connecting locomotive numbers with other boys. Ah, just like now. Who we do not know, but who enjoy the same thrill as an express approach at speed. Like me, actually. So this is a marvellous painting I found with a clock, and it's just like a busy city with a train on the right. And with cars, it's just like a busy traffic jam. Now it's Waterloo Station because it says here, Waterloo Station. Terence Cunio in 1967. He began his professional career as an illustrator. In the 1940s, he produced a series of travel posters for the London and North Eastern Railway. This is his own architecture, I think. That's pretty nice. This is the rocket. And it will say here, this is for my grandma, by the way. Georgia Rocket Stevenson, oh, I remember this, had no time to pilot the ideas of the small model from the Rainhill Trials in 1829. Competition to choose a locomotive to form the first intercity passenger service. They invested their hopes in rockets. Blah, blah, blah. Yeah, this is the rocket.
Right, so we're going to go to the Great Hall right now, where you find the Eurostar and all the other stuff. So we'll see you at the Great Hall.
Great Hall, we're in.
Now let's explore. This is the Eurostar.
Stupid cameras blow. Oh,
okay.
Here's the Eurostar, TBMST, train the class 373.
And this is one of the locomotives of the Eurostar, TBMST 373. And I love the semaphore signals as well.
So this is the bullet train from Japan. And I like the nose bit a bit better. Kind of looks like an aeroplane. And here's one of the Class 800 trains. They've probably been displayed there recently.
And we've got another Eurostar locomotive here. Brilliant. We should add the Class 374.
And we've got an Intercity 125 HST train.
Parked up over there. And we can see the nose bit of it.
Now we're going to see the model railways.
Here we are in the model railway.
This is the class 31 in blue livery, and I'll show you the end of it. Here it is. And we also have a turntable here for the HST. The steam trains.
And this is called Sir Kenneth Range, Intercity 125. Just walking around the turntable, not on the turntable, just walking to the other train we're going to see. It's in yellow and blue livery. We miss those trains so much.
Now here's an interesting one, Livingston Thompson. There's red engine, says Fastenyok Railway number 3, 1885, Boston Lodge Works. Here's the cab, Fairlings Patent. We also have these trains. Over there is the BR Car 52, which is on the Diesel Legends, which I actually play on Trains of All 2, the add-on for Great Western Express. I think this one's the Rocket. Here's the classic one, the Mallard. Sorry of the sun. Stupid sun. Anyway, here we go. Mallard. This is one of the oldest trains, I believe. Number 4468.
Actually, let's go on the other side.
Okay, here we go. Mallard.
These are the Mallard trains. And they're no longer in service.
Apparently, it's the fastest ever steam train in the world. This is the Mallard experience, which means you can do simulation. You can drive this train as a simulator. This one is going wobbly, wobbly, wobbly.
Means it's moving. Okay guys, thank you for watching.
about the National Rowing League. Don't want to make this film too long, but I'll film other things that are different edits. But anyways, thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed everything. I enjoyed it too. I'm still going to be here. Anyway, see you later. Bye.